It's true. It's not real funny. I was trying to think of something funny that happened, but so you just get what you get. When I was like 16, Bob would come to Waco and visit with Daddy, and they would sit in the living room and just talk for hours, and I'm like, what in the world could they be talking about that long? And I'm, you know, back in the, my room listening to the Yardbirds and the Rolling Stones and, you know, how it was to be 16 and 19, or whatever that was. 66, you can do the math real quick. Anyway, they would talk and talk and talk, and Bob would finally leave, and then they'd sit out in the front yard and talk for a while, and my mother would go, those damn cigars. She would have to smell it, boy, we opened up and everything aired out, whatever. But they was always talking about putting the band back together. And so,
okay.
Have to keep it clean.
Yeah. Anyway.
So anyway, it actually happened. We had about a month and a half run that Daddy and Bob got Jesse Ashlock, and Tag Lambert was playing guitar with him at the time. And they had Curly Hollingsworth on piano. And Bill Mounts played drums, and the steel player changed from gig to gig, but this 16-year-old kid was playing bass in that band. And Bob would pick on me every night. Who's that kid back there? You know? Anyway, I was lucky. Daddy recorded one night of it, so I was a wee Texas Playboy for 4 weeks. And Daddy didn't even, you know, warn me or coach me about this or anything. We just went and played. And back then, they didn't plug basses into electricity. It was, you just have to pick real hard. And then it was easy to hide back there if I didn't know the song real good. But anyway, we always opened the set with, Daddy called his band the Home Folks. So Johnny Gimble and the Home Folks would do a few numbers. And then Bob would walk out on stage, and it was just... It was magic. It was just like this energy, and this, his psyche took over the place. It was amazing, even for a dumb-headed 16-year-old kid that liked the Kinks and the Rolling Stones. That blew me away. How much? I probably even played better than I would have. So anyway, there's my story there. No punchline, but it's kind of cool. Well, you gotta drop names when you can. Bob Gimble.
Dick Gimble. That's my name dropping right there. Let's do a little.